So,
you got a slow computer and a big complex scene in Blender. You wish you could show everything in the viewport, but it's just too slow. There are many ways you can optimize your scene. One of the best and most accepted solutions in the animation industry is creating proxies. Proxies are simplified geometry representing another object. Instead of showing everything as is in the viewport, you specify a proxy to be shown in the viewport instead. When you press render, the proxy is not used and the high quality mesh is used instead. Blender artists often overthink creating proxies and think it's not worth the time spent creating them. I'm here to tell you it's not, and there are three quick and easy ways to create proxy meshes. The first one is even built into Blender. Let me show you. So we got our default scene. Let me just add a Suzanne just so it's slightly more complicated of a mesh. But for this first solution, you simply go to your object properties, you scroll down to the subpanel for viewport display, and then you change the display as to bounds. And that's it. You've made a proxy. This bounds makes a box as your proxy for your render. Because of course, with render image, it still renders the Suzanne. Oh, you don't believe me? You don't believe that drawing bounds actually makes an impact performance? Let's prove it with some numbers, shall we? So you can see this viewport playback's going about 80 frames per second. I obviously have the frame rate really high just to really test the computer. Now if I change this to bounds, and as you can see, this is already going up to 100, 110 frames per second on average. Now you may not want to do this for your entire scene. Obviously a composition of boxes isn't really helpful for the viewport. So let me show you two more options. Now let's bring this back to textured. Now let's get into modifiers. Now there are a couple modifiers where it has separate viewport and render settings, specifically subdivision surface. So you can do that with the shortcut control 1, 2, and 3. Actually I might even go up to 4 if I want to. Yeah, fun fact. You can see that the viewport levels is not the same as the render. So if I do render for 4, but subdivisions in the viewport for 1, render that. And you can see that's the much denser geometry than what's here. Well, let's say you got modifiers that don't have that. What about bevel? Now you notice these little toggles up here. This actually allows you to disable modifiers in the viewport or render. In this case, we can just disable it in the viewport. So once we've decided what we want, we can make these a little bigger. Well, it's actually clamped, so that doesn't matter. I can disable that and still have it beveled in the render. So Blender is effectively making a proxy for the viewport and just reevaluating it for the render. And you can even have it of where you still have it enabled in the viewport, but have it disabled in edit mode, which is really useful for cases like this where the geometry that's changed kind of gets in the way of how you're editing the mesh. And so sometimes I'll just leave it off. While you may not think of this as a proxy, it's effectively doing the same thing. In Blender's case, it's just evaluating the modifier differently based on whether you're in the viewport or in the render. So once you've got your object in a workable state, make sure you turn off modifiers when you can. And lastly, manual proxies. Now manual proxies doesn't sound straightforward, but let me show you how easy it can be. So with this, let's re-add our subdivision and apply it for demonstration purposes. And let's actually add our statistics so we can see how much geometry I have. So 62,000 triangles, I guess 63, rounding up. We'll move into new collection just for convenience. So we'll do Suzanne. Our first step is to duplicate. So with duplicate, I'm gonna Shift D is the shortcut. And we're just gonna right click to keep it where it is currently. Now the reason I made a point to say Shift D is because I don't want these objects linked. I don't want these two meshes to be linked to the same mesh, because I want to be able to make changes to the proxy mesh without affecting the render mesh. So we're gonna keep that unlinked, and then let's rename this just so it's obvious that it's the proxy. So do underscore proxy. Now up here in the filters, we're gonna add the disable in viewports toggle so we can disable things in the viewport and unload it from memory. Now, if you're unfamiliar with visibility settings, I would highly recommend you watch my other video in this optimization series on visibility settings. And so with the proxy, it's as easy as, well, we want to keep the proxy in the viewport and then disable it in render. So we disable it from the render. And with the high quality mesh, we want it not in the viewport, but still in the render. So we disable it in the viewport. And now with this proxy mesh, we can do whatever we want with it and it won't affect the render. So if I do this, move that vertice just for demonstrations, untouched, perfect. And now how do we want to simplify this mesh? There's a couple options. The easy ones are decimate modifier. I'll make this ratio really small for demonstration purposes. So you can see that's already down 600 triangles. Now with proxy, make sure you apply modifiers when you can, just so that way Blender doesn't have to reevaluate those modifiers. So just apply that and you're good to go. Now the other option is we'll go into edit mode, and there is a hidden convex hole operation with Blender. You can find the convex hole operation in the mesh menu for convex hole, or you can just search it with F3. That's how I usually do these as well, is just search it and click that. And now it creates a mesh that kind of surrounds and wraps around the original mesh. The best benefit about it is it works really fast with even big meshes. So if Decimate seems too slow for you, Convex Hole works really fast. Now, of course, you miss a lot of the details. Of course, any concave details are missed in this case, but in some cases, convex holes work really well. Now, the benefit with the collection, that's the reason why I added the collection, is now every time I instance this, so we're going to add the Suzanne instance, it is using the proxy. Blender keeps these visibility settings in mind, so with the instances, those proxies are respected. So I can just link duplicate this as many times as I want, and it still uses the proxy. So this is great if you have a prop used everywhere. Instead of having to change each one and adding a proxy for each one, you make it an instance, and then you just add a proxy mesh within that instance. That's it. So that's how easy it is to create your own proxies. Now, of course, there are more complicated use cases, like with rigged characters, or if you're wanting to toggle back and forth between proxies. I actually have an add-on called Proxy Plus to handle those use cases specifically. But if you need something more ambitious and automatic, I'm helping code a new add-on for ViCube Animations to handle those cases. So do me a favor, check his channel out, and be on the lookout for that new add-on. I'm really looking forward to the launch of this product, not just for you guys, but also so that way I can get back to my other art projects and my other tutorial ideas for you guys. I actually have quite the backlog of video ideas, so if any of these interest you, please let me know in the comments. Oh, what? Most of my audience isn't subscribed? Would you like to change that? Anyways, thank you for watching, happy optimizing, and happy blending.